like phosphorus.
Hey, what is up guys? This is JoeKingJohn74 and today I'll be teaching you guys the best class setup for the Odin Assault Rifle here in Call of Duty Modern Warfare. So let's start off with the Gunsmith. First things first that I want to mention with you guys is that this weapon is strong as hell. It takes around 2 to 3 bullets per enemy to be taken down. So like around 5 enemies can go down with one single mag. That's how strong this weapon is. It kind of also acts like a sniper rifle because I've sniped people off the rooftops when it comes down to the district map. And it is that freaking strong. The way I have it set up is like half assault rifle and half sniper. So that's how strong this weapon is. And also one keyword I'll keep on saying in the whole video is recoil. You really need to control that recoil because without any of these attachments, this gun will become useless. You want to use this gun at its full potential, and this is the way that I have it set up. It's going to be used at full potential. So first things first, I want to talk about the Colossus Suppressor. It increases your damage range, also a little bit of recoil control, supposedly. To be honest, there's no recoil control, even if it's just by itself. But like, it's strong as hell. It keeps the damage range, so that means the damage will be consistent overall when it comes down to long range combat. Next thing I would like to talk about will be the barrel, the Odin Factory 810mm. Now this attachment is quite important because it also increases your damage range again. So not only would it have the effect of a sniper, I mean the damage will be there at all times. That's why this weapon, it takes down an enemy within 2 to 3 bullets because the damage range is on its max at this point. So the bullet velocity also increases, so that means the recoil will increase a little bit more, but at the same time it does have a recoil control supposedly. So it's very confusing because at the same time I just don't feel the recoil control when I'm using the weapon. So like just by itself, when I had only the suppressor, Colossus, and also this attachment by itself, the recoil will still be out of control. So you gotta add more to it. So next thing I wanted to talk about will be the underbarrel, which is called the commander, the commando foregrip. Now this attachment is very important. It also it also controls the recoil. You know, as you can see, the recoil stabilization, also the aiming stability. The more of this that you have, the better the gun is used at its full potential. The damage will always be there, and also it will be quick to react when it comes down to close quarters combat, but not as fast. But it will try its best to like really keep up with the speed when it comes down to medium to short range combat. So it is quite important to have something like this to really be consistent on the damage and be quick about it when it comes down to medium range battles. So yeah, that's why you need the commando foregrip. Any other thing will probably be like throwing off the gun a little bit more. So the next thing I would like to talk about will be the stock. The stock attachment increases the aiming stability, which also pretty much controls the damage. The more perfect, the more controlled your weapon are, pretty much the damage will be consistent, and that's why I keep telling you guys this weapon can take down an enemy within 2 to 3 bullets, because the damage is always directly towards the enemy. It's not going all over your screen, it's directly towards the enemy. So this is very important to have. The next thing I want to talk about will be the optic. To be honest, you can have whatever you want, like whatever you can have, like the VLK or the Viper, but to me, like, I'm feel more comfortable when I'm using the APX5 holographic sight. This attachment just allows me to see a more clearer view when it comes down to medium range combat. So I enjoyed using the sight a lot, but whatever you feel comfortable with, you can go ahead and use it. So this is the way I use this weapon, the Odin Assault Rifle. It is a strong ass weapon. It hasn't been nerfed yet, so it's still stronger than the freaking Scar. And I've used the Scar for a little bit. I was beast with it, but I've started to notice the Odin is just taking down enemies pretty easily within a few bullets. So the more bullets you save, the better you are ready for the next enemy, which this weapon allows me to be at all times because it's that freaking strong. But there is some kind of like I'm gonna tell you guys a little bit of the cons. It is quite bipolar when it comes down to close range combat. When somebody pops into your face, it takes like around 4 bullets to take down, which is pretty weird. So I don't know about that, man. That's pretty, is that kind of reversed, to be honest. When it comes down to long range combat, this gun is a beast, but when it comes down to like close range combat, the weapon becomes one of the weakest weapons out there, which is pretty weird. So I don't know, man. I mean, I have the max range, you know, out there, but it's still weak as hell when it comes down to close range combat. But when it comes down to long range to medium range combat, this weapon is just an easy takedown, and it's just 2 to 3 bullets per enemy. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this best class setup. If you guys have used it, let me know in the comment section. If you guys have your own setup, about the Odin, let me know in the comment section. I'll probably use it, and I'll give you credit on my next video. And maybe if I do like beastie with it, like I said, I'll give you guys credit. So that is it, guys. That's the best class setup for the Odin. The rest of the class is just a point maker, because I do have the perk point man, so I'm just making points here and there, especially with the third might lethal. So because that's a tank killer, so every time you kill a tank it's like 250 points plus, so and then plus an objective, and then plus one more kill, you get the first spy plane right away. So this is my point maker class, but I'm not gonna explain the whole thing yet until I can perfect the whole thing. As far as I know, the Odin is a strong ass weapon. So that is it, guys. If you guys want to learn more about Call of Duty Modern Warfare, subscribe for more, because it's gonna be more content like this coming up.